stunning looks, then swift.
Sri Lanka had to sweat it out to make it here. Afghanistan pushed them like very few would have imagined they could. But they are into the Super Fours and they're going to kick their Super Four stage off with a clash against Bangladesh, with the tournament now having moved back to Sri Lanka for its conclusion. Joined by Farveez Maharoof to set us up for that contest. Farveez, thank you as always for your time. Let's start with the bowlers. They've had contrasting outings, rampant against Bangladesh at Palikele, but given that almighty scare by Afghanistan in Lahore, you'd imagine they'll be happy to be back home.
Absolutely. What a game that we witnessed against Afghanistan. No one thought it would go for you know, that conclusion. But I'm pretty sure Sri Lanka will be very happy to be playing at the Arbhamdasa Stadium. Sri Lanka has a very good record there. The crowd is like the 12th man, and I'm pretty sure the local crowd will get back to them and you know, support the Sri Lankans who have been tested out in the last game. But I'm pretty sure still they have not bought their A game, and hopefully they will bring it down in the all-important Super Fours.
What can we expect from the surface at the R. Premadasa Stadium as the tournament moves there for its conclusion?
Yash, your guess is good as mine, Yash. I mean, so many things being said. All I can tell you, let me tell you this story. The ACC Emerging Asia Cup, which happened a couple of months ago, was supposed to be held at another venue. But last moment, they had to shift it to R. Premadasa Stadium. And before that, prior, 3 months before, the pitches were relayed, the top player was relayed, and all of a sudden they had to play at Arvindas Stadium. And the pitches were decent enough. But the time which had for the pitch to bind in, and the groundsman, which you know they initially planned, did jeopardize with the last moment change in venue. So I don't think come ACC Emerging Asia Cup, once it finished, all of a sudden they had the LPL, so many games were played at LPL. And the pitches were very different. Sometimes, you know, we predict something and all of a sudden we see something else. So, you know, it's very hard to predict. Even the Afghanistan-Pakistan ODI, which was played at R. Premadasa Stadium, the pitch was having so much bounce unusually. So, with this weather around, I'm not too sure what to expect. But all in all, I reckon it's a test for every team going to be, because no one knows what's going to be there.
Right, thank you for that. I thought we need to keep our fingers crossed for the weather, but we'll keep them crossed for the pitch as well. Let's see what is rolled out. But we can expect the conditions to definitely not be as easy on the batters as it was in that quick trip to Pakistan in Lahore. That does put pressure on the batters. Fortunately for Sri Lanka, they have Kusal Mendes, who will carry the confidence of that 92. But is Dasun Shanaka's continued lack of runs becoming a big concern now?
Absolutely. I think it's a major concern for, you know, the entire group, and not only the entire group, the entire country, because his numbers are so poor in the probably the last, I think, 9 or 10 innings. So he needs to up the game, and coming up, World Cup is going to be very important. I'm pretty sure the Sri Lankan team will be announced any moment from now onwards. So I reckon Captain Dasun Shanaka got to step up to the plate, because luckily for him, team is winning and it's on a run. I think Sri Lanka has won about 11 ODIs on the trot. So I think at the moment, he's just hanging by its thread when it comes to, when it comes to his captaincy, if I'm being really honest to you, since the team is playing well and team is winning. But I reckon he has to step up as soon as possible. Word on Kusal Mendes, so happy he's among the runs. He's the vice captain of the team, leader of the pack when it comes to the batting order, with the ability. You know, I kept on, you know, backing him, because I knew when he comes good, you know, he makes sure that Sri Lankan will win single-handedly. So it's an important game for not only Dasun or Kusal. It's going to be important for entire team, because always you need to start well in a Super Four tournament such as an Asia Cup.
Yeah. How much are you going to read into the group stage meeting between these sides just last week? Sri Lanka dominated that one. What can that inform us about what to expect this time around?
I think massively. Confidence will be boosted by that win. I mean, going into the first game, even everyone said it's a 50-50 game, because Bangladesh had many experienced players. But the way Sri Lankan bowlers bowled, especially with so many first-choice bowlers not playing, was very impressive. So going into this game, psychological effect will be with Sri Lanka, as well as, remember, Najmul Hasan Shant, the man in form, is not playing. And that's going to be a major factor for Bangladesh. So if Sri Lanka can squeeze in a few wickets with the new ball against ordinary middle order of Bangladesh, who is lacking form, I think they could hurt them even more.
Got one last vital question to ask you. We didn't see any snaking around in that last meeting in the group stage. Do you expect any nuggets coming out this time?
Well, as a spectator, as a pass player, I would like to have some good nuggets coming out in the field. One or two bowlers, being in the past, which happened in 2008, is always good because you need spiced up in the middle. And for viewers like us watching from outside, we need that. So hopefully, one of the players from each team will bring it out, and we'll see a spicy game coming up.
We're going to hope it's a cracking contest. Thank you so much, Farveez Maharoof, for helping set it up for us. Build up to the game starts just before the toss on Maruti Suzuki Arena. Presents ESPN Cricinfo Match Day, powered by JBL.
Stunning looks, then swift,